I can't figure this out, Dr. Oz. I get that you do a lot of good on your show. I understand that you give a lot of information that's great information about health, and you do it in a way that's easily understandable. You're very talented. You're obviously very bright. You've been trained in science-based medicine. Now, here's three statements you made on your show. You may think magic is make-believe, but this little bean has scientists saying they found the magic weight loss cure for every body type. It's green coffee extract. Quote, I've got the number one miracle in a bottle to burn your fat. It's raspberry ketone. Quote, Garcinia cambogia, it may be the simple solution you've been looking for to bust your body fat for good. I don't get why you need to say this stuff, because you know it's not true. So why, when you have this amazing megaphone and this amazing ability to communicate, why would you cheapen your show by saying things like that?
Well, if I could disagree about whether they work or not, and I'll move on to the issue of the words that I used. And just with regards to whether they work or not, take green coffee bean extract as an example. I'm not going to argue that it would pass FDA muster if it was a pharmaceutical drug seeking approval, but among the natural products that are out there, this is a product that has several clinical trials. There was one large one, a very good quality one, that was done the year that we talked about this, in 2012.
I want to know about that clinical trial, because the only one I know was 16 people in India that was paid for by the company that was in fact, at the point in time you initially talked about this being a miracle, the only study that was out there was the one with 16 people in India that was written up by somebody who was being paid by the company that was producing it.
Well, this paper argued that there was no one paying for it, but I have the five papers actually, plus a series of basic science papers on it as well. But Senator McCaskill, we can spend a lot of time arguing the merits of whether green coffee bean extract is worth trying or not worth trying. Many of the things that we argue that you do with regard to your diet are likewise criticizable. I mean, should you be on a low-fat diet, a low-carb diet? I've spent a good part of my career recommending that folks have a low-fat diet. We've come full circle in that argument now and no longer recommend that, many of us who practice medicine, because we realized it wasn't working for our patients. So it is remarkably complex, as you know, to figure out what works for most people even in a dietary program. Even in the practice of medicine, we evolve by looking at new ideas, challenging orthodoxy, and evolving them. So when I hold, you know, these are the five papers, these are clinical papers, and we can argue about the quality of them, very justifiably. I can pick apart papers that showed no benefit as well. But at the end of the day, if I have clinical subjects, real people having undergone trials, and in this case, I actually gave it to members of my audience. It wasn't a formal trial. It was just an
Which wouldn't pass. The trial you did with your audience, you would not say that would ever pass scientific muster.
No, I would never publish the paper. It wasn't done under the appropriate IRB guidance. That wasn't the purpose of it. The purpose was for me to get a thumbnail sketch. Was this worth talking to people about or not? But again, I don't think this ought to be a referendum on the use of alternative medical therapies. Because if that's the case, listen, I've been criticized for having folks come on my show talking about the power of prayer. Now, again, as a practitioner, I can't prove that prayer helps people survive an illness. On the other hand,
you don't have to buy prayer.
It's hard to buy prayer. That's the difference.
Prayer's free.
Yes, prayer's free. And people, that's a very good point. Thankfully, prayer's free. And so but I see in the hospital, when folks are feeling discomfort in their life, and a lot of it's emotional, when they have people praying for them, it lightens their burden. And so my show was about hope. I wanted, and as you very kindly stated, we've engaged millions of people in programs, including programs we did with the CDC, to get folks to realize that there are different ways that they can rethink their future, that their best years aren't behind them, they're in front of them, they actually can lose weight. So if I can just get across the big message that I actually do personally believe in the items that I talk about in the show. I passionately study them. I recognize that oftentimes they don't have the scientific muster to present as fact, but nevertheless, I would give my audience the advice I give my family all the time, and I've given my family these products, specifically the ones you mentioned, then I'm comfortable with that part. I do think I've made it more difficult for the FTC is that in an intent to engage viewers, I used flowery language. I used language that was very passionate, but it ended up not being helpful but incendiary. And it provided fodder for unscrupulous advertisers. And so that clip that you played, which is over 2 years old, and I've done hundreds of segments since then, we have specifically restricted our use of words. We are literally not speaking about things I would otherwise talk about. There's a product that I've never talked about in the show that I feel very strongly about because I know what will happen. I will say something very, in fact, we did a show with Yacon syrup, which you did not bring up. There was a South American route that had a big study published on it, I think a very high quality study, where they showed not only did it help people lose weight, but more importantly, help their health. It was done in women who are diabetic, done by an academic center down there, was not funded by industry. And we talked about it, and I used as careful language as I could. And still, there were internet scam ads picking one or two supportive words where, of course, I support them. I wouldn't be talking about it otherwise.
Well,
it still ended up out there.
I'm surprised that you are defending. I mean, I've tried to really do a lot of research in preparation for this trial, and the scientific community is almost monolithic against you in terms of the efficacy of the three products that you call miracles. And when you call a product a miracle and it's something you can buy, and it's something that gives people false hope, I just don't understand why you need to go there. And it's something that gives people false hope. I just don't understand why you need to go there. You've got so much you do on your show that makes it different and controversial enough that you get lots of views. I understand you're in a business of getting viewers, but I really implore you to look at the seven, and I would ask you to look at the seven lists that the FTC put out on the gut check. It's very simple. Causes weight loss of 2 pounds or more a week for a month without dieting or exercise. Causes substantial weight loss no matter how much you eat. Causes permanent weight loss, like you said, dieting or exercise. Causes substantial weight loss no matter how much you eat. Causes permanent weight loss, like you said, looking for to bust your body fat for good. If you just look at those seven, and if you spend time on your show telling people that this is the seven things you should know, that there isn't magic in a bottle, that there isn't a magic pill, that there isn't some kind of magic root or acai berry or raspberry ketone that's going to all of a sudden make it not matter that you're not moving and eating a lot of sugar and carbohydrates. I mean, do you disagree with any of these seven?
Senator Casco, I know the seven. I say those things on my show all the time.
Well, then why would you say that something is a miracle in a bottle?
My job, I feel, on the show is to be a cheerleader for the audience. And when they don't think they have hope, when they don't think they can make it happen, I want to look, and I do look everywhere, including in alternative healing traditions, for any evidence that might be supportive to them. So you pick on green coffee bean extract. With the amount of information that I have on that, I still am comfortable telling folks that if you can buy a reputable version of it, and I say this all the time, I don't sell it, and these are not for long-term use. And by the way, with green coffee bean extract as an example, it's 1 pound a week over the duration of the different trials that have been done. That happened to be the same amount of weight that was lost by the 100 or so folks on the show who came on, and half of them got a placebo. We actually got fake pills, gave it to half the people, real pills to the other half, and it's sort of the same thumbnail. I'm looking at a rough idea. If you can lose 1 pound a week more than you would have lost, doing the things you should be doing already, you can't sprinkle it on kielbasa and expect it to work. But if that trial data is what's mimicked in your life and you get a few pounds off, it jumpstarts you and gives you confidence to keep going. And then you start to follow the things that we talk about every single day, including all those seven items. I think it makes sense.
Well, I'm going to give time to my colleagues now, and hopefully I'll have a chance to visit with some of the other witnesses in the next round. I will just tell you that I know you feel that you're a victim, but sometimes conduct invites being a victim. And I think if you would be more careful, maybe you wouldn't be victimized quite as frequently.
Senator McCaskill, those topics you mentioned are over 2 years old. I have not been talking about products in that way for 2 years. And it has not changed at all what I'm seeing on the internet. And frankly, it's getting worse. So I completely heed your commentary. And I realize to my colleagues at the FTC that I have made their jobs more difficult. That's why I came today.
Good.
I'm cheerleading for this process. I want to do anything I can to help, but if taking away those words doesn't change the problem, it's already happened.